I welcome you all for the today's session on careers in HR. I'm Professor Nupur Veshne, working as assistant professor in Department of MBA, KLS Kopte Institute of Technology. I'm sure all of you have a lot of concerns and questions in your mind at this point in time. What is the program that I should choose? Which is the field that I should choose to make my career? Which college should I opt to take up my further education so that I can build a successful career? Everybody has a lot of concerns at this point in time regarding all of these things. So I can help you to answer few of your questions that are coming up in this period of time. So here, my session will focus on how can you make a career in HR by choosing a program called as Master of Business Administration, and how we at MBA at GIT help our students to make a career in HR. Now, why human resource may be right for you? When shaping your ideal career path, it can be just as important to know what you don't want to do for the next 10 to 20 years as it is to know what you want to do. What comes to your mind when you think about what you want from your career? A very tricky question. Perhaps you already know what you have on your don't list. That is, I don't want to have a high pressure work environment. I don't want to have tight deadlines. I don't want to travel most of the times on my job. I don't want a target oriented job. Or I don't want to sit at one place and work. I want a challenging environment. So many things that can be there on your don't list. For example, are you comfortable with being at your desk for most of the days and most of the time? Or do you want to move out of the desk, move away from the desk, talk to different people and professionals? So these could be various things that could be on your mind. So you're already clear about what is that you want to do and what is that you don't want to do. So when you have this clarity, when you already have a don't want list, you need to also look upon what is there on your want list. You might want a profession that offers you a chance to help people, understand their problems, give strong opportunity for growth, work with variety of tasks, work on a robust job market and possibly even telecommunicating opportunities and flexible work hours. If any of these things are there on your want list, considering a career in human resource may be right for you. Because this is what human resource can offer you: talking to people, understanding their problems, working in a robust job market, giving opportunities to people, and various things. So human resource or HR profession is a consistently higher ranked career based on job growth, earnings, or earning potential, creativity, flexibility, and various other factors. So it's very important for you to know what do these HR professionals do, because only when you know what they do, you can try to relate yourself of what you want to do and what you can do, and then choose this particular career. Today, business success depends on careful management of all resources. And one of the important resources today is human capital. There are various important resources like men, machine, material, money, but men, that is human capital, is playing a very, very important role. Human capital today is an asset to the organization, which is only such a set which can bring competitive advantage and a long-run sustenance for organizations. Money can be raised, resources can be bought, machineries can be purchased, but it's very, very essential to acquire the right talent and retain that talent over a period of time. That is what is going to bring you competitive advantage, and that's where HR professionals work. So workers at all level contribute to their company's sustainability and profitability. And human resource management maximizes these contributions of people by carefully overseeing recruitment, hiring, training, compensation, change management, and various aspects. These are no doubt, all of these are support functions, but without these support functions, and organizations cannot survive. HR managers often consult the top management on the organization's directions for employee development and strategic planning. They help their companies remain viable by attracting top talented people, recruiting the best candidates for each position, and enabling employees to develop their skills and potential so that they can benefit themselves as well as the company. It is always a two-way process. Gain is not only of the company, but the gain is also of the individual. Hiring the right talent is no doubt very essential for the company so that they can contribute to the profitability of the company, but at the same time, the company which extracts profitability from an employee also gives in return a lot of benefits to the employee, and that's why it's a two-way, a mutually beneficial process. And that's where HRs play an important role. HR managers connect the value of human capital to the company's bottom line. They are the people who connect between people and the company. There are various roles. No doubt, you know, people have a lot of understandings about HR, that HR is, HRs do only hiring, payroll management. They are only trying to manage the numbers of people who are absent and how many people have reported. But no, gone are those days. HR's role has evolved over a period of time, that they have taken a place in the core strategic role of the organization. No doubt there are a lot of myths that you people may be having related to this particular profession. There could be myths like, the days of human resource field are numbered. It is wrong. In fact, human resource field is predicted to grow at a very higher rate in the coming days, which makes it one of the most fastest growing fields. Comparing to the past growth rates that this particular career option has been seeing, the future growth prospects are very, very high. So the myth that the human resource field is going to remain for only a few days of time is wrong. Second myth that most commonly people have is careers in human resource don't pay. It is very untrue. For human resource managers, there is no limitation of salary. It is all based on what are the competencies that you can contribute to the organization, what kind of growth prospects can you show to the organization, what profitability can you bring to the organization by helping the organization manage the human capital resource. So salary is not a limit. Salary is always based on what you can contribute, and it is not based because you choose a particular field. The third myth that people often have is you can only go so far in career of human resource. That is, the career opportunities are limited. Now that's a false. false understanding. It has no limitation. In the past, it has been seen that most of the CEOs of the companies are the people who come from HR background. It's not that only people coming from other specializations become CEOs, but even people from human resource background or people who have chosen human resource as their career are becoming CEOs. So, career growth or growth opportunities never have limitation as long as you want to aspire those career opportunities and work towards it and climb the ladder. It's not that only people coming from marketing, finance, productions go to that level of becoming a CEO. There are various examples that people, though working in the field of HR, have also become CEOs of organizations. So growth opportunities are never a limitation because you choose a particular career. The next myth, you will not have much interaction with senior executives in the company. This is again wrong. Because of their expertise in human capital management, human professionals or human resource professionals are often called upon by senior management to consult and advise them in matters involving strategic decisions. Like you can see, if any organization wants to acquire, that is, they want to go for acquisition. Now, acquisition, no doubt, is a matter of financial ability of the company to buy a particular organization, but it's not only that. It's not only acquiring a particular organization, but with the organization, there are people also who are acquired. Now, it's very important, there are many acquisitions which have failed because people of the acquired organization do not get gelled with the acquiring organization. And that's when the HRs play a very strategic role in understanding what kind of people are working in the acquired organization and how can they gel with the acquiring organization, because these two organizations have been different, their cultures have been different, their values have been different, and if these can be matched, two organizations can come together and the acquisition can be successful. Even for that matter, even when the organization wants to merging these two companies coming together and forming a new company. And for this also it is required for two people, two organizations, not only come together for advantages like maybe market, growth or profitability, but that merger can be successful when the people of two organizations want to come together and when they can come together and work, the merger will be successful. In these kind of decisions, the HRs play a very vital role in understanding the people sentiments, the people values, the culture, and how they can be molded towards contributing to the organization's profitability and sustainability in the long run. So HR's role today has evolved from only managing the payrolls and attendance of the employees to contributing towards strategic decision making. Specifically, they are involved in advising top management on ways to manage employees that will result in achieving the best possible productivity and budgetary goals for the company. They are playing a very, very vital role today. Another myth that most of the people have is all human resource professionals do is hire and fire. That's what I was just talking about. It's not only about hire and fire. They're not only there to hire people and fire people. But HR's role has evolved in many roles today. They are not only hiring and firing people. It's not about manhandling people today. It's all about managing employees' skills, knowledge, ability, their values, beliefs, which can be all focused and directed towards organizations' sustainability and profitability, which can be mutually benefit to both the company as well as the individuals. So to do this, They are performing various roles. HRs are trainers. They are looking into training and development. They are looking into recruitment and hiring, compensation and benefits, understanding people requirements and designing a right pay package, which is beneficial both to the company as well as individual, is very, very challenging. HRs are doing that. They are taking a role of a change agent. They are taking a role of organization development role. So there are various roles that they are contributing. They have moved ahead, moved quite far only from managing the payrolls and making attendance towards contributing to this strategic decision making. So the myth that they are only doing hiring and firing is a wrong myth. So you can see that HR's role is a very elaborative role. It's not limited to a particular field. They are playing a very vital role in shaping the organization towards, you know, a growth-oriented organization by managing the human resource, which is a very important asset of the organization. At the same time, the asset which is at high risk. But because every company is looking for the best talent. Today you have the best talented employees, but if you do not nurture, if you do not develop them, if you do not retain them, tomorrow they will be with your competitors, and that's a great risk. So it's very, very essential for the companies to hire the right people, at the same time retain those people, so that the organization can have long-run sustainability and profitability. And there is where human resource plays a very important role. So now that we have spoken so much about what is HR, what is the career, you know, why you should make a career in HR, how should you, you know, try to relate yourself to this field, let us understand what are the qualities that is needed in a good HR. No doubt there are various qualities that you must have commonly heard that what HR, what a manager should have. Like they should have the ability to manage, direct, control, right? And they should have good communication skills, initiative taking, leadership quality. These are all common skills that every individual should have according to me. Because it is essential. These are life-saving skills. If you want to survive in the job market, these are the skills that you will require. But specifically, if you are choosing a career in HR, what are the skills that you will require? There are four skills that I would like to highlight that would be very essential if you want to make a career in HR, apart from all other skills that I was just talking about. The first skill, problem solving. Problem solving, the way of thinking, is a way of thinking. Now, what is that problem solving skill? It's analyzing, evaluating, and creating new ideas. As an HR, like I told you, you have to talk to various people, understand their problems, and come up with solution to their problems. Because I just said, you're not manhandling people. You are managing people's mind. Knowledge, skills, and abilities are an effort of mind. So if you're able to manage an individual's mind, you can get the right kind of knowledge, skills, and abilities, and you can direct them and focus them in the right direction, which can contribute towards organization's growth and profitability. So you should have, as an HR, one should have an ability to evaluate, analyze, create new ideas, so that you can convince people. Now, if you can understand the person's problem, evaluate it, come up with alternate solutions, you can convince a person to do the right things. Right? Because you cannot force, you cannot manhandle a person and force him to do a particular task until unless he is not willing to do it, he will not exert right efforts. You may force him to do a particular task by penalizing him, but you cannot force him to put the right amount of effort by penalizing him. The right amount of effort an individual will exert only when he is convinced, why should I put this much amount of efforts? So So HRs have to play this role of convincing people of why they should do, what they should do, how they should do, and what is required for them to do this particular task. So problem solving is one of the very essential skills that an HR should have. Another important skill or quality that HR should have is collaborating with various people. In a completely globally connected world, employees are supposed to be able to function in any environment. Today, the world has no limit. It's a global world. It's a we call it as a global village. Companies, profession, work do not have boundaries today. With globalization, companies move in, every country for expansion, for growth, for profitability, for sustainability, and because of which people have to keep moving from one country to other country. So employees need to have that ability to function in any environment. This requires to function in any environment, in any kind of culture, this requires language skills and adaptability. Suppose if you have to try, if your company subsidiary is located in some other country, if it's located in Germany, you need to have the language skills of working in that particular environment, because you cannot survive until unless you know the local language. You need to have that adaptability to adapt new cultures so that you can work it effectively. And you will have to also work with different types of people who may be having different, who may come from different cultures, from different values, from different backgrounds. And to work collaboratively, you need to have a greater understanding of each other. And for that, you require collaborative working skills. Another important quality that is required is social intelligence. Now, what is this social intelligence? Human resource people need to understand what different target groups want and what motivates them to take decision. Like I just said, it's a global village, it's a global world. Any person sitting in any part of the world can apply for any job, can work in any country with any company. It means that people from any country can come to work for your company, and they come with different motives, with different expectations. So HR should have that ability of social intelligence, of understanding the different motives, expectations of different target groups, so that you can design practices that could be acceptable to all. And the fourth quality that an HR should have is creativity. Creativity is a quality that every individual should have, but even HRs should have. That is, HR should be able to come up with new working methods, improvements, and come up with original ideas which make the organization stand out from the world. Creativity is required in every aspect. It's not that creativity is required only in production, research and development, marketing or finance, but creativity is required in even HR. Creative practices which can attract the talented workforce, people to come and work with your organization are very, very essential. So these are certain skills that an HR requires. Now, coming to the most important thing, now that I've spoken why you should choose career in HR, what happens in career in HR, what can you expect from careers in HR, and what qualities you should have in order to make a career in HR. The most important thing, what do we offer at MBA GIT to shape your career in HR? We do a lot of things at MBA GIT to shape your career in HR. If you choose a career in HR, to build the skills required, the qualities required for an HR, there are numerous activities that we do. No, I just spoke about problem solving ability. Now, how do we develop the problem solving ability of our student? The kind of pedagogy that we use, the kind of syllabus that we have designed, the kind of tools that we use helps the students in order to develop their problem solving ability. One of the most important methods that we use here is the case method of teaching, which helps you to develop the problem solving ability. We bring real time or simulated case studies to the classroom so that students can get access and understanding about what are the real-time problems and how they can approach in order to solve these problems. This particular method helps these students to acquire the problem-solving ability. We are tied up with IIM case studies. We make use of IIM case studies. We have a license with IIM Ahmedabad in order to use their case studies for using in the classroom. We make use of Harvard case studies. Now, this is what we do in order to develop problem-solving ability. Now, coming to collaborating with various people, how do we develop our students to adapt to various types of environment? We organize a lot of events on the campus. We support our students to participate in events outside the campus, intercollegiate events. Our students participate in various events, organized or in various states. We conduct industrial visits, local, national, as well as international, so that our students can visit to the companies, talk to people, understand the problem, learn how to interact with various types of people, adapt to different types of environment when they move for national or international visits. Right? This will help you to develop an environment wherein students are able to acquire collaborating with various people and working in different types of work environments. Social intelligence. We conduct a lot of team projects, group activities in-house, as well as we allow students to participate outside, and that helps the students understanding towards each other. Working in teams will help them understand each other's expectations and then come up with the right kind of strategy to work. Creative thinking. We organize, like as I said, we organize events like new product development, packaging, right? We give free platforms to students to demonstrate their new ideas. If their ideas are really workable and if they want to really practice their idea, we have incubation center wherein we give support and assistance for our students to practice their idea till they are successful, and then they are able to convert it into an enterprise. We organize events like Avalanche, Aura, wherein students can participate with their creative ideas. They are given a lot of platforms where they can demonstrate their creativity through their work. So if you could see, for whatever qualities that are required for you to make a career in HR, we at NDIGIT are helping our students to acquire those qualities and build your career in HR. So when you choose any career, always try to relate yourself. What is that you don't want to do and what is that you want to do? And then when you have your want list, try to identify what is that, what are the qualities that you have. Match it with your want list and then choose a particular career. Do not choose a career, may not be only in HR or marketing or finance. It should not be chosen only because your friends are doing, your parents are telling, or what the market trended. It should be all based on what you want to do. Whichever, every field has its own scope for growth. No field has limitation. Right? So HR also do not have any limitation. You can grow at any extent, at any level that you want to do. It's only the right choices that you need to make. So this is what I had to speak about, how you can make careers in HR and what is that we offer at NDIGIT to shape your careers in HR. Thank you.